itself. So it's been a great year for mutual funds. Let's get in a mutual fund expert itself. R. Srinivasan of SBI Mutual Fund joins in to talk about the year that went by and how to approach 2013. Srinivasan manages Magnum Equity, Magnum Global and Magnum Emerging Businesses Funds, which by the way was ranked one in small and the mid-cap category and has given a return of 49% in the last 1 year itself. Srinivasan, thanks so much for joining us on the show. First up, how are you approaching the year 2013? Do you think we could in any way replicate the gains that we saw in 2012, or do you expect it to be a year of consolidation?
Well, honestly, even at the beginning of 2012, I wouldn't have expected the market to be up 30% odd and our fund to be up 50%. So I guess we are taking it the same way like we were at the start of 2012. So I hope it's a good year.
So do we, Srinivasan. Hi, morning. The problem though is that even though many funds, including yours, have had spectacular performances and in many cases, you know, beaten the benchmark indices, the flows or the redemptions have just been unrelenting through this year. What's your own experience been, particularly on some of these mid-cap funds? Are you facing a lot of redemption pressure or is interest beginning to pick up on mid-cap categories now?
No, we actually having a problem of plenty, especially with this with the Magnum emerging business. We've seen the size grow up to almost 1100 crores, and that's traditionally been we've been largely into small and mid caps. Small caps itself have been almost 40-45% of the fund. So we've seen flows, and that's kind of diluted the way we manage the fund. So we've got much more large caps there. But I guess what you say is definitely true for the mutual fund industry as a whole.
Sure. I'm just looking at some of the holdings that you have in global and emerging business where there's banking, financials, and you do have a couple of NBFCs like Muthoot Finance in both these funds. What's the story that you like about NBFCs, Srinivasan, and any concerns about valuations as many have pointed out?
No, not really. Muthoot, for example, so these are specific stories. They aren't really a top-down kind of an NBFC investing. So Muthoot is a stock that's been beaten down. It's out of favor. I think they're in a business that generates very significant return on equity, and they've been doing well in terms of growth. So there was this RBI regulation against gold loan companies, which kind of raised concerns on growth. But I think that's kind of in the price, and that stock has done pretty well for us. And then the other stock we have is Shriram City Union. I think we like the story there. We like the customer access that they have, the growth potential they generate. They've been generating significantly high return on equity consistently for the last many years. And Muthoot, definitely, I don't think there is a valuation concern at all. The stock actually is inexpensive. Shriram is trading at close to 2x, which I think is okay for the kind of consistency it's delivered. They've done like 23% ROEs, and there's no reason to feel that they'll fall short there.
Within the mid-cap funds itself, banks and consumer themes have done quite well in 2012. If you had to look ahead to 2013, where do you see the good performance coming in from with respect to individual sectors?
Honestly, our mid-cap style of investing is bottom-up. We don't really have we've played out this consumer theme, and we're still very bullish on it. So when I say consumers, they're not the heavyweight consumer staple names where we actually underweight the likes of Lever and ITC and Nestle. But the niche names, we've been holding them for quite some time, like Page, Hawkins, you'll find them in our funds, Agrotech. I think that story is still very much on, and that's a long-term secular story. And valuations are still not as expensive as you see in the heavyweight consumer names. So that banking is something where we've been selective. We've been playing the private sector much more than the public sector banks. So you've seen some volatility there. The stocks have come off. The mid-cap public sector banks, they've gone up too, but we haven't really been in that roller coaster.
You have a pick in the aviation space as well in your top holdings, SpiceJet. But the one that's really kicked it out of the fence this year has been Jet Airways, Srinivasan. Would you churn your portfolio in the aviation space, perhaps take a risk with Kingfisher Airlines? Or do you think holding on to SpiceJet is a good thing to do?
No, I think SpiceJet makes a lot more sense. So if you look at Jet, what Jet is trading at more than almost $1 billion. Kingfisher's debt itself is a couple of $1 billion. And SpiceJet, even after the run-up, so it's almost doubled. That's still at $500 million. And it's not like the market shares are very different. Kingfisher obviously right now has hardly any market share. But between Jet and SpiceJet, SpiceJet still has a 17-18% market share. So SpiceJet clearly, for the kind of market share that it has and the kind of valuations that you're getting it at, it definitely seems the cheapest of the lot. So we haven't gone in detail on Jet Airways, and Kingfisher obviously is something that's it's too speculative right now. You've got to figure out how much of a haircut the banks will take a call on the stock. Otherwise, the stock itself fundamentally is not worth anything.
You've also got Amara Raja, which is an interesting one, Srinivasan, and it's always attracted a fair amount of fund interest. You like that story enough to hold on with it? You think it's good for more?
Yeah, that's always done phenomenally well. So they've done well, they've gained market share, they've consistently performed for the last many years. They actually enjoy a very high return on equity, but the stock has been kind of undervalued. So even today, relative to an Exide or relative to companies who generate that kind of a profitability, it's probably still undervalued. But it's seen some bit of a re-rating, and I think it's come on the back of strong earnings growth and market share gains. So that's a stock we continue to like, and we own quite a bit of it.
Just wanted you to flesh out the point you were making about inflows into the global fund and the emerging business fund, Srinivasan. Has your AUM increased on both of these? And what exactly has the experience been through the last 2 months, which is when the market has begun to pick up? I mean, what kind of inflows have you seen?
No, we haven't seen inflows in Magnum Global. We've only seen inflows in Magnum Emerging Business. I presume that is on the back of the fund performance. So I don't think it's specific or I don't think you should read investor behavior based on that.
Okay, Srinivasan, we wish you luck. Good performance. Hopefully that should last. And small ray of sunshine on the point that you're making about your funds. Inshallah, next year we will see some more retail interest and flows coming in from the domestic side. We need it. We need that.